Good morning, students. Once again, welcome to my maths class. This is Srinivas from ZPHS 4. Okay, children. So far, we have been learning about the chapter circles. Many concepts we have learned about a circle, what is a circle, radius, and segment, and recently, what is the semicircle and what is a sector. So I hope you understood well, and you all having in your mind all the definitions of the circles, isn't it, children? That's good. Okay, I appreciate you. Now today also we're going to learn one more other concept in circle. Okay, na? Okay, be ready, children. That's good. Let us be ready now. See, what is this? Just observe, angle subtended by a chord at the center of the circle. This you have to listen properly. Angle subtended by a chord at the center of the circle. What is the angle subtended by a chord at the center of the circle? We know about angle, we know about the chord, we know about the center. So now we are going to learn about this full sentence. Okay, angle subtended by a chord at the center of the circle. Okay, let us see. This is a circle, of course. That is circle only, we know very well. And then this is the center of the circle. Okay, now take two points on the circle, point A and point B. There are two points I have taken. Can you see, children? Okay, good. Point A and point B. These two points on the circle I have taken. Now join these two points. AB is called, if you join any two points on a circle is called chord. Yes, that's good. This is a chord. Now from this chord join to the center. Again, I mean from these points, end points of the chord, again from this also join to the center. Now what we have done, taken two points on the circle and joining from this end points of the chord to the center. Angle subtended by a chord at the center. That means what is this angle? What can you say about this angle? See, this chord subtends an angle at the center. Okay, if you join only, you will get the angle here. For example, let us calculate this angle. This angle is, see, this is the chord. From here to here, we have to calculate by using protractor. For example, if you take a protractor and place like this, once more I'll show you. If you take a protractor and place like this, then you can easily measure the angle of this center, I mean angle subtended by a chord at the center, isn't it? So let us take out the compass, I mean protractor. So take another, for example, this is some 60 degrees. This is some 60 degrees. Okay, I'll show you once again. See, this from here to here, 10 20 30 40 50 60 70 degrees is there. For example, this is 70. Okay, then take another point on the circle, and here also another point on the circle. Now again join both these points. See, this is the chord. Now we are joining another chord by taking two points on the circle, C and D. These two points join. Now if you join, CD is a chord. CD is a chord. Now observe, AB is a chord, but it is smaller than CD. CD is somewhat big in length. Okay, so CD is a chord which is greater than AB, or AB is a chord which is less than CD. CD is more length and AB is having less length comparing to CD. Okay, again let us join these two. C, from C to the center of the circle. Again from D to the center of the circle. Again measure what is this angle. What is the angle? COD. This one we have to measure. Previously we have measured this is 70 degree, isn't it? That is AOB. This is 70 degree. Now, in addition to this 70 degree, little more is increased the left side and little more is increased the right side. For example, take this is some 10 degree or 20 degree and this is also 20. 20 plus 20, 40. Now 40 is increased. 70 plus 40, 110 degree now. So angle COD is equal to 110 degree. Isn't it? This is 110 degree. See, chord length is increased, then the angle made by the chord at the center also increases. This is the main point you have to observe. Chord length is increased, then the angle also increases. Let us take again two more points on the circle. Give the names E and F. E and F. Again, join these two again. E to O and F to O. Again, this is the radii. And join E and F. This is a chord. See, AB is a chord. CD is a chord which is bigger than AB. Now, EF is a chord which is some more bigger than CD. So, here chords increasing, isn't it? Now, again observe the angle. Now, we have to take the angle from here to here. That angle we have to take. Now, this is 70. 20 plus 20, let us imagine. It's not exactly 70. Okay, imagine like that. 70. Now, 20 plus 20, 40. That is 110. Again, here some 20 plus 20, again it is increased. This is 40. 110 plus 40, 150. So total angle is angle EOF, that is equal to 150. Now see the children, what happens? The chords, length of the chords are increasing, then angle also increases. Angle AOB 70 degree, angle COD 110 degree, angle EOF 150 degrees. So what we can observe by this activity? If the lengths of the chords are increasing, then the angle made by the chords at the center also increases. That is what angle subtended by a chord at the center of the circle. What is the angle subtended by a chord at the center of the circle? If the chord increases, angle at the center of the circle also increases. This is what we can state. So let us see the statement. Angle subtended by the chords at the center of the circle increases with the increase in length of the chords. So if length of the chords increases, then the angle at the center also increases. So by this experiment, we can establish or we can state like this. Okay, if you want, you can do at home. Take draw a circle and just join the chords. One is smaller, again bigger, again some more bigger. Take a protractor and calculate the angles at the center. This is what about the angle subtended by a chord at the center of the circle. Okay, children. Now, here EF greater than CD greater than AB. Already explained. EF is greater than CD is greater than AB. So, angle EOF is greater than angle EOF is greater than angle COD is greater than angle AOB. Angle EOF is greater than angle COD is greater than angle AOB. Okay, let us go for the next concept in this. That is angle subtended by a chord at a point on the circle. Remember, see, the previous one is angle subtended by a chord at the center of the circle. This is at the center. Okay, now angle subtended by a chord at a point on the circle. So what is this means? Not at the center, at a point. Let us observe. This is a circle. Now again take two points on the circle. Now join. Okay, this is the chord, because angle subtended by a chord, we are learning about chord. Chord is making an angle. Where it is making? At a point on the circle. So on this circle take a point, then what is the angle it is making? That is what we have to observe. Okay children. Okay, now let us take one point on the circle. So this is the point on the circle. For example, C is a point on the circle. Now if you join AC and BC, see, O is the center. Now AB is the chord. AB is a chord. Now from this endpoints of the chord, we are joining the point which is on the circle. That is what? A point on the circle. So chord is making an angle at a point on the circle. That is what? What is this angle? For example, now let us join to the center also. Center also. If you join, for example, if you take this is 100 degree. Now previously we learnt, you know, angle subtended by a chord at the center of the circle is 100 degrees. Now what is the angle subtended by a chord at a point on the circle? This is what we are learning now. See, this is the angle subtended by a chord at the center of the circle. This is 100. Now what is the angle subtended by the same chord at a point on the circle? That means here, what is the angle? It is always half of this angle. Observe children, this is 100, so this angle is 50. It is always half. Since we are learning about this one, chord at a point, so let us say in a reverse manner, converse manner. Angle subtended by a chord at a point on the circle is half of the angle subtended by a chord at the center of the circle. We can say like this. Or in other words, angle subtended by a chord at the center of the circle is two times angle subtended by a chord at a point on the circle. Twice. If you take from year to year twice, sorry, from center to on the point, if you take half, from on the point to the center, if you take, it is double. Double or twice. Okay, this is the relation between these two. See, this is a chord. It is making on major arc. This is on major arc. Now what about this minor arc? See, this point can be taken anywhere. Now if you take the same point on this minor arc, what happens? Let us take, this is a point D. Now join AD and BD. Now AB is a chord. This chord making an angle at D. Now what is the relation? See, now don't see this one, 100. Now we have to see this one, this angle. See, total is 360 degree. Already 100 degrees is gone. Now what is the remaining? 260 degrees. So that is 260 degree. Since it is 260 degree, as I said in the previous, I mean, this 100 is half to this point. Now this 260 is half. Take half of 360 on 30 degrees. Same concept. angles obtended by an arc at a point on the circle is half of the angles obtained by an arc at its center. Both are same. If you take half, or if you say like this, in this manner, that is double. So I give you angle at the center is doubler than the angle at a point on the circle. Point on the circle, if you take first, then it is double. Okay, now we can see here representation from the diagram. We can represent like this: angle AOB. See, angle AOB. Angle AOB is equal to 2 times angle ACB. Angle ACB. Since angle ACB 50, so 2 times is 100. That is angle AOB. So angle AOB is 2 times angle ACB. This is a minor arc ACB. I'm sorry, this is major arc. This is wrong. This is major arc. Okay, now this is on the major arc. Okay, next one, angle AOB, again same. Angle AOB is equal to 2 into angle ADB. AOB, that means this one, this is major arc. Yes, it is correct. Major arc A, angle AOB, this is angle AOB, 260 degrees, that is equal to half of ADB, or ADB is the angle at ADB is half of angle at AOB. So angle AOB, like this we can say half, or we can say double also. Angle AOB is equal to 2 into angle ADB. Okay, this is this is minor arc. Here it is minor arc, and this is major arc. That's good, children. I hope you understood. Okay, so angle at the center is doubler than the angle at a point on the circle. Okay, children, that's good. I hope you understood well. Isn't it, children? What we have learnt here? Angle subtended by a chord at the center of the circle. That is one concept. And next one is angle subtended by a chord at a point on the circle. That is second. And the relation between the both. Isn't it? The relation between the both. That's good, children. Thank you so much for having listened my session. Thank you so much. Keep watching my channel. This is Srinivas from Jetpatches Double Four. Thank you. Bye-bye.